That what you said earlier about your constitutional right, every citizen will tell you their constitutional right to be a governor or president, as the case may be. But what vision or what plans do you have?
I have a lot.
Even though that means if the people begged you, that means you have no plans. You have no vision.
Let me tell. No, I have plans. Let me tell you. A lot of things. I started something. There was a place I put it. There was a place I stopped. And you want me to continue from there? Let me tell you what is happening. You see, you can't, when you good governance, if people have tasted something and they cannot have it again, they'll clamor for it. It's not like if your wife has been cooking a very good soup for you and you have been enjoying that soup and stop cooking that soup, you will tell this woman, why are you not giving me that soup again? So the same thing, I gave them good governance in my 4 years. Good governance is that I brought governance to the doorstep of every citizen of your state. Every citizen of your state had access to me at that time. Accountability and transparency. I was very close to the people I was governing. I had a program every last Thursday of the month throughout my 4 years in office. We call it Epa de Governor. Epa de Governor literally means meet your governor. They have access to call me, and I told the producer, anybody calling me, don't censor any phone call. And a week to that time, they'll be doing promotion of that program for anybody who cannot have access, who has got access to telephone, to write a letter to me that I must reply. So those are some of the things you are no more enjoying, and they want me to come back.
In 2016, you granted an interview.
Yes.
And you said, you were quoted to have said, as someone, well, you said, you will not have known what to do if you had won. That was after 2015 elections.
Yes.
That was because the resources
No. Yes, you see.
You said you pray it does not go beyond that. What do you mean by that?
Before that I wouldn't.
When they asked you about the dwindling resources in the states and how the challenges they face paying salaries, you said, well, that you've not been able to sleep.
Yes, I just said so about 2 weeks ago. Let me tell you why I said I don't be able to sleep. Why would I pay salary?
No, you said you will not have known what to do, and you pray it doesn't go beyond that.
I will have known what to do. Later on, I got to know that it's misplacement of priority. I got to know that because I don't have facts and figures at that time. But when I asked access to facts and figures, I saw that it was misplacement of priority.
Okay, tell us then.
There is no way anybody would not pay salary. It depends on how you prioritize your needs.
Okay, well, we also looked at this MBS Annual State Viability Index. In that report, they said the IGR of Oyo State was 20% of their receipt from Federation account. And that was going to be challenging. But the governor, I think he said this month, or on a monthly basis, that they're targeting 4 billion naira IGR. So what economic plan would you have such that you move Oyo State towards being fiscal independent from the center?
Yes, you see, what people don't know is this. Because our country is, we have a mono economy, everybody dependent on the dough from Abuja. We decided we are complacent. We are not trying to move the way we support to move. I once asked my uncle, who was once working in the local government, I asked him when he was working in local government, whether they were waiting for money from Lagos then, when Lagos was occupied. He said no. He said they were paying salary and doing everything through IGR. So what I will do is this, aggressive IGR.
What will be your target?
Revenue.
On the monthly
my
or
target,
annual basis?
My target, if possible, will be 50% of what I'm getting from Abuja. My target will be 50% of what I'm getting from Abuja. And you see, what is obtainable at your state, we can get it.
So which agencies?
We can get it without even putting any burden on the people of your state.
So how are you going to achieve that?
Yes, we get the rich to pay for the poor. And we know them, and we know how to get them to pay. and we know how to open the identity. I started it before I left office. I would have gone so far that if I were to be, because I started it, that I know what I was going to do. And you want to introduce, if you want to introduce a new tax system, it has to be gradual, so that you don't seem being unnecessarily difficult or unnecessarily put a body on the citizenry of your of the state. So I don't want to do, and my target will be 50%.
Some others raise concerns, saying, look, if Oyo State has 157 billion naira debt profile with a 10 billion naira monthly expenditure, leaving 4 billion naira deficit, how much of a tax are you going to get to meet this?
That's one of the things that I'm going to address if given that opportunity once again. When I was in the office, I made bold to say that I did not owe cover before leaving office. I even left in the comfort of the Oyo State government about almost 10 billion naira. I did not owe any bank, I don't owe anybody, no ISPO, I don't owe anybody. If what you are telling me is correct, I don't know the debt profile. If the debt profile is correct, I would not know how to order. I will order my priority, what to do first and what to do next, and I will know the legal. I would like to know what is the legal, and binding the payment of that loan. Then the loan, you see, you have to ask question when you see such high debt profile.
Why didn't you find out what the debt profile is?
The Information Act is not being properly implemented.
You're a former governor, you have your sources. It's just a phone call.
A phone call. You see, what you don't know about government is that even a civil servant, after you leave office, we even find you got to greet when he sees you outside, after leaving office.
Maybe because he didn't treat him well while you were there.
Not because I didn't treat him well, because he's afraid that they will say you are still loyal to, that the incumbent will not say you are still loyal to him.
What's your take on this minimum wage matter?
Thank you. Minimum wage. They should need each state to determine what the minimum wage should be. Let me tell you where I'm saying so. Where we borrow our system of governance, that's the presidential system, in America, a New Yorker will not take the same pay with somebody from Ohio or Florida. So you can compare Lagos State. If you are paid, if they're paying 30,000 in Lagos State, and you want your state to pay or pay 30,000 naira, it is unfair. You know, Lagos State can do without Abuja. Lagos State can do without Abuja.
Yeah.
But some of the states cannot do without Abuja.
Okay.
So, and as such, I don't want to allow each state to determine what the minimum wage he wants to pay.
All right. We'll anchor at that point. We've been speaking with Otumba Christopher Alawakala, former deputy governor for your state and the governorship candidate of ADP. Thank you for coming on this program, sir.
Thank you very much for having me. Goodbye.